G'day, my name's Darcy.
Happy?
No, I don't think I've ever been happy.
And this summer, I've been working with drones in one of the most remote parts of Canada, the Mackenzie Mountains. I've been working alongside Vanessa.
Well, you got some shelter up in those trees if you need it.
She's the owner and sole operator of one of very few drone companies that are based this far north. And we're going to be working out of this remote camp together, where she has only 1 week to collect all the data that she can, because this plane that services the camp only comes once a week. The reason we are out here is to create this, a 3D image of the mountain. And the thing that collects this data is this drone. It flies around in a pre-programmed grid pattern.
You got all these lines? See the lines there?
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to fly these lines and it takes photos like this.
Collecting photos and LiDAR, which are then meshed together to create this 3D image. This data can then be combined with other sources of data to create an enhanced package of information for the client.
What are the different colors?
Elevation.
Oh, okay, and red's so, the highest point?
Yeah,
yeah, that's
purple
the
is the, yeah, purple is the lowest.
Yeah, and then what are these tripods for you? I see you've got two of them now.
This one is so that the navigation system on the drone is a little bit accuracy. It's not relying on a crappy GPS, it's relying on something that's a little bit more accurate in space, like down to a meter, not 20 meters.
Okay, so once again, just increasing efficiency.
Yeah, especially when you're on steep slopes.
Yeah.
It's just to make sure that the mission direction that it's flying along steep cliffs, it's holding that line that it's supposed to.
Yeah.
Because any deviation, especially like the last job we just did in the Killarneys, like it's like this with glaciers and stuff. And if you don't have a good elevation model and it's offline, then you're going to have an accident.
So if the drone's doing all the work, then why do we need the helicopter? These drones can only operate line of sight from the controller, which Vanessa has. And some of these properties are 50 miles from camp. So, in her pre-planning, she divides these properties into blocks. As she's very familiar with the terrain, she knows exactly where the helicopter needs to park in order to get as many blocks completed from the one area as possible.
And then we're going to shut down on the saddle and we'll do a fuck ton from there.
This is what a normal day will look like for us. Right after Sparrowfart, we're going to load that machine full of Vanessa's gear. We're talking GPS receivers, tripods, batteries, and the drone itself. Ironically, we also bring a generator with us to recharge the batteries on those long days. This is the green movement in a nutshell, and why I'm not afraid of drones taking my job as a pilot. I'm going to be topping up the machine full of fuel so we can spend as much time out in the field as possible. It's only us two and the little bit of gear that she has, so weight is not going to be a problem. Less weight, more fuel. Then we jump in the machine and head on out to the property. Now, because Vanessa's already done her homework the night before, she knows exactly where all the GPS receivers, tripods, everything needs to go. So the first thing we're going to do is drop off these GPS receivers. They help with the accuracy of the project. Orange spray paint is then used to mark the position of the GPS receiver. This A helps later in the data analyzing process, and B helps us find the receivers at the end of the day.
Shit, where do we put it?
Yeah, I know.
I feel like it was just before it started to go up a hill.
Work, it was back from here, I think.
I still think it's up here a little bit.
I don't think it's, yeah, I think it's further back that way, to our tail.
There it is.
Once we've put out two or three of those bad boys, we're going to find somewhere, usually perched up high, where we can see the drone line of sight. We're going to shut down and set up the tripods. The tripods are the mothership to the GPS receivers. Then it's just a matter of putting the drone together and pushing the start button.
you don't really need to control it.
All the everything is about the planning, about efficiency.
Okay.
It's really just about knowing how long your battery's going to last, how many spots you can get, how many missions you can get from one spot, where the helicopter can land, all that kind of stuff, you know. And then all I do here, because I think I can do 6 from here, so it's just a matter of fucking hanging out and just changing batteries.
And hanging out is what I do best. The thing is, sometimes I'm not good at sitting still and I need to go on a side quest.
It's 8 o'clock in the morning here. Vanessa's got her drone going and she's opting to do the northeastern side of the hills while the sun's still good. So I've made an admission of mine today to go climb this mountain rather than sitting around in the helicopter wasting my life away. So I climbed all the way up here to this snowpack. I thought it was a snowpack, but actually, glacier buried under here. It's insulated underneath all this rock. That's why it stays frozen. Beautiful day here in British Columbia. I'm sat with the drone lady. We're stopping at these places for an hour or so each time. So I've just been going for little walks. Got my radio on me in case I see an animal that I don't like. Let her know what my final moments were. I was just going to try and get to the top of that mountain. I reckon I could do it in about 15 minutes. We're about 45 minutes in. I've made it about 300 meters, so I might have overestimated my abilities. But powering on. So the trick when you're out on these sort of jobs is to find the perfect chill area, somewhere where you could just park up and switch off and enjoy life and just take it all in. And so here, for example, I found this little spot in the shade. Well, the sun angle is quite low. It is only 10:30, so soon it will be in the sun, but for now it works. I've got this little mossy pillow to lie my head against. And then looking forward, we have this glacial blue lake. There's a glacier up there. It's melting, you know, global warming and whatnot, you know. It's not much you can do. And there's the heli parked up. So it's quite a rocky terrain. Hence why I was searching far and wide for this spot for about 30 minutes. So here we are, doing the best we can. But it's not all sunshine and rainbows. Quite often, we are fighting the weather.
This is really starting to fucking piss me off.
See, when the drone takes off, it goes straight up 500 feet, and that's where it starts taking the photos.
Yeah, I've got to be 200 meters above all these peaks, mapping all this shit.
But there's no point of it taking photos if it's in the cloud.
Just fuck off.
The image is just going to come back as white.
There's literally only about 4 or 5 things I can do right now.
So, we really need to work around the weather.
It just means a lot of fucking around because, yeah. Like, I planned it so that we do a whole bunch from one spot and not fucking jump 10 times a day.
Yeah, I get you.
And because we've only got a week to do the project, we really need to be smart with our time.
We might do a bit of stuff there, and then if it's not improving, we'll go back over there and do the LiDAR. And hopefully by that stage, we've got enough time to burn a bunch of shit off.
It's also no good when the rock face is in the shadow.
We're just going to fly this face. Can't do much on the other side because of the sun. I hate mountains. I fucking hate them.
Oh, you'd love Saskatchewan then.
That means doing what we can, when we can.
I can't do anything more here until the afternoon. By the afternoon, it should be hot and all this shit should have burned off.
And working around the weather.
There's going to be so little I can do here. I don't think I can do much here at all.
But when it's good, it's bloody brilliant.
You know what they say? Any landing you walk away from is a good landing.